Good morning and welcome. Please join in singing the summons, and we'll sing verses 1, 2, and 5.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we want to welcome all of you here today. We want to welcome all of our visitors. We thank you all for coming, especially with the snow coming down right now. We also want to welcome all those who are watching us live streamed right now, or who will watch us later in the day as we celebrate the third Sunday in Ordinary Time. Let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to sinners. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, saying, "Set out for the great city of Nineveh and announce to it the message that I will tell you." So Jonah made ready and went to Nineveh, according to the Lord's bidding. Now Nineveh was an enormously large city. It took 3 days to go through it. Jonah began his journey through the city and had gone but a single day's walk, announcing, 40 days more and Nineveh shall be destroyed," when the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, and all of them, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw by their actions how they turned from their evil way, he repented of the evil that he had threatened to do to them. He did not carry it out. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I tell you, brothers and sisters, the time is running out. From now on, let those having wives act as not having them. Those weeping as not weeping. Those rejoicing as not rejoicing. Those buying as not owning. Those using the world as not using it fully. For the world in its present form is passing away. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. As he passed by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." Then they abandoned their nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in a boat mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in the boat, along with the hired men, and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. My brothers and sisters, when I was a student in Rome, there were certain passages of Scripture, both Old Testament and New Testament, that were cited in many different classes. The beginning of today's gospel was one of those passages. Over and over, we were taught that the words of Jesus in Mark chapter 1, verses 14 and 15, were the core of what the historical Jesus preached when he lived and walked among us. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Since COVID began, we have been very limited in our ability to provide religious education and faith development for adults. Therefore, in my homily last weekend, I introduced FORM. As I mentioned, we might describe FORMed as Netflix for Catholics. This week's bulletin once again contains a flyer explaining how to sign up online. In several recent homilies, I've mentioned our search for meaning and equated our search for meaning with our search for God. In fact, last Sunday I even said, as Christians, we believe that we only find the true meaning of our lives, we only find God if we find Jesus. Do any of these situations or stories sound familiar? You get a big promotion, but it doesn't make you happy more than for a day or two. You buy a fancy car, but the thrill is over by the time you pull into the garage. Your team wins the Super Bowl, and all you have to show for it was an expensive journey with someone else's name on it. The things we expect to fulfill us, the things we expect to make us happy, don't. Centuries ago, the great Saint Augustine explained this phenomenon when he wrote, "My heart will never rest until it rests in you, O Lord." In other words, God created us with the desire for the infinite, that no one or nothing besides God can satisfy. The Augustine Institute has created an award-winning video-based series that is turning heads as it explores fundamental questions and mysteries like these. The series is called The Search, and the national reception to it has been so enthusiastic that we are bringing it here to our parish, to Little Flower, during Lent, for all of our spiritual benefit and growth. The Search is a multi-part, video-based spiritual experience from the producers of the FORMed online platform, to which we've recently subscribed. The production is beautiful, none of this rec room or fake library feeling to it. The well-known Catholic evangelist Chris Stefanik hosts The Search. But The Search is meant not just to be watched, and it's certainly not meant to be watched alone. That is why we're beginning to form small groups, both in person and virtual, to watch, discuss, and truly benefit from The Search. If your faith is already solid, The Search will help you to deepen it. If you're feeling unsure, it is for you too. If you're worried about your children or grandchildren, it is a great series for you to share with them by bringing them along. The Search features artists, scientists, philosophers, and other people from all walks of life proclaiming how their searches for meaning in life led them to Jesus and the gospel. There's nothing quite like it in the Catholic world. The Search proclaims the gospel in words that modern ears are ready to hear, and images that modern eyes cannot help but see and remember. My brothers and sisters, in today's bulletin, you will again find information about how to sign up for FORMed. Also, we will be emailing you this week, inviting you to sign up for The Search. Last week, I invited you to sign up for FORMed, which is the platform. Today, I'm inviting you to sign up for The Search, the program we will be presenting during Lent. The kingdom of God is at hand. Reform your lives and believe in the gospel. Please stand.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Having been enlightened by God's words, let us bring our needs before the author of all truth on this Sunday of the Word of God.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, and especially this weekend for the church in Latin America, that God will grant us the courage, wisdom, and resources to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, may God unite us in peace and respect for each other and for human life at all stages, and may we work tirelessly in defending the lives of the unborn, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our elected officials, that they may perform their duties honorably and with integrity while holding a special concern for the least of those whom they serve, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who share in the ministry of this parish community, that we will bring compassion and understanding to all those we encounter, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in times of illness and turmoil, our merciful and loving Father will strengthen our faith and trust in his goodness and divine providence, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for progress made in the fight against COVID-19 and for healing for those who are ill, protection for those who are vulnerable, and an end to the pandemic, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our beloved dead, may they live in glory forever with God and all the saints, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of Father Bob, this morning's special Mass intention, and for all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of eternal love and light, you have given us Jesus as your incarnate word. Hear our humble prayers and grant us the grace and courage to proclaim your gospel through Christ our Lord. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for our salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Therese, the little flower, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Now let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
to fishermen who lived along the Sea of Galilee, stood by the shore to cast their nets into an ageless sea. Now Jesus watched them from afar and called them each by name. He changed their lives, these simple men.
This weekend, there is a special collection to help support the church in Latin America. There are special containers at the church doors for your donations as you leave Mass today. Enrollment for the 2021-22 school year at Little Flower School is opening soon, educating students to be passionate, social justice-driven individuals in a family-centric environment is our specialty. Please see this week's Chorizen for more details about our virtual open house on the 31st on how to schedule a private tour.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Please join in singing You Walk Along Our Shoreline, verses 1 and 3.